Hi, I'm Izzy Kornblau.
And I'm Kira Deneen. We are recording from NBC Universal Stanford Studios today.
We should probably say we are both genetic counselors. I'm a cardiovascular genetic counselor.
I'm a prenatal genetic counselor. I also host a genetics podcast where usually we're not doing really fun stuff like this of looking at pop culture and where genetics pops up. Usually I'm talking about more genetic counseling topics and other genetic related research and technologies and all kinds of stuff like that.
So definitely make sure to check out DNA Today. I'll leave a link down below.
So this first clip is from Glee.
Hey, I know it's not my place, but have you had your doctor run the full genetic test panel on your unborn child? I only asked because my cousin Leon and his wife got pregnant, and then they found out that he was a carrier for tay-sachs.
What's that?
It's a genetic disorder. Pretty terrible from what I understand. If one of the parents is a carrier, then there's like a 50% chance that the child has it or something like that. No, Leon's baby was fine. It was still pretty scary, though.
My doctor never mentioned that.
You know, I'm such an idiot. They would only run the test if one of the parents was Jewish. Yeah, only Jews carry the gene.
Oh.
Okay, well, I'll see you in rehearsal.
All right. Wow. What do you think, Izzy? How well did Rachel Berry do at genetic counseling?
I would say a very solid 0 out of 10.
0 out of 10. I don't know. I give her 2 out of 10. She
really?
Has some,
she
some
has
information.
She has compassion. And
I don't know about the compassion, but she okay. did get it right that tay-sachs is more common.
That's correct.
In the Jewish community. And
that
if
is
people
true.
Have ancestry from there. But not that it's only in people that are known to be Jewish.
And certainly not if you're a carrier. The risk for your child is not 50%.
No.
Actually, it requires that both parents are carriers.
Yes.
And if both parents are carriers, then there's a 25% chance that the child will have tay-sachs.
Yes. And she did get it right that it is a very severe condition. So I think that part, she had an understanding that it is a condition that is very serious.
Yeah.
And really, really sad when we do look at kids that do have the condition. And that it is genetic screening. But the way she phrased it was like, oh, do all the genetic screening on your unborn child. Like, it was comical the way that she phrased it.
Yeah. Usually this kind of screening would be called carrier screening. And we would do it either before a pregnancy or during a pregnancy. And you would actually be testing both of the parents, not the pregnancy. Unless both parents came back carriers, then we could talk about testing the pregnancy.
I actually got to interview one of the actresses from Glee.
What?
Yeah, I didn't tell you this. That's so funny.
That's crazy.
Lauren Potter. Yeah, she is so sassy and amazing. She plays Becky Jackson on the show. She has Down syndrome, and she came on my show a couple of years ago to talk about her experience being a Down syndrome advocate and also working with Jane Lynch and everything and being
That's
her right-hand woman. So, I have a soft spot in my heart for Glee.
So this is from Broad City, best show ever.
Hilarious.
I saw this clip. It's great.
What's the character's name?
Alana.
So Alana, I think, is opening up her results. That's a direct consumer result.
Yeah.
Mommy, my genes and me results came. Okay, I am
100% Ashkenazi Jew. Yeah, no shit. Ever seen a mirror? Wow.
Okay, we have history of anxiety.
Check.
Poor eyesight.
Check.
IBS.
Yeah, well.
Tay-Sachs disease, cystic fibrosis, fragile X syndrome. Holy shit.
Let me tell you something, honey. I could have told you all of that without your selling your medical history to the government. What do you mean?
Google owns your DNA, you naive little bitch. Well,
I'm going to write all about this for my grad school personal essay.
Endophenotypes, the genetic inheritance of mental disorders.
Yikes.
All right, what do you think, Izzy?
What do you think, Kira?
I think it's interesting. She opens it. She's like, I'm 100% Ashkenazi Jewish. I thought that was really funny. But that, I mean, some people do get that result.
My mom.
Okay. But usually also it gives you what countries you're from and even like counties. So I know when I've done it with different companies, it tells me like a big chunk for me is Ireland and specifically East Cork, Ireland. So it does get more specific than that. But
the reason is actually,
yes.
Are you Ashkenazi Jewish at all?
I am not.
Okay.
No.
So unfortunately, they don't really get more specific than that.
Oh,
which
because
is
it's already
so upsetting.
So specific.
It's already pretty specific. They can say like Eastern, Western, and they can identify. Like my dad's Sephardic, my mom is Ashkenazi, so like they would definitely be able to tell the difference between that. But like Ashkenazi, it's kind of like in the East part of Europe. That's the most specific you get, unfortunately.
I mean, it is specific. It's just not specific to geographic location.
Yeah, it's not as exciting.
Yeah, that is interesting. And then she's a carrier of that many conditions that are all like not a lot of them are common to Jewish people. So that was interesting. Like, cystic fibrosis isn't one I think of.
It's like 1 in 25 for anybody with European ancestry, Jews included.
Okay. So it's somewhat. But then to also be Fragile X, and I think she said something else.
Like, Fragile X is also, like, it's totally different. Like,
yeah. Yeah.
Like, if you find out you're a Fragile X carrier, there's a lot more to be discussing because right. the risks are very different because it's an yeah. X-linked condition, and there's also risks for the person themselves as a carrier.
Yeah, definitely. And that's a common finding that will come up in prenatal, and then I'm sitting down with patients and going over a lot of information if Fragile X does come up. And that's one where we're not testing the partner. So we said earlier, like, oh, with tay-sachs, you have to look at both parents' carrier status, but Fragile X is an exception to that rule because it's yeah. X-linked Fragile X. What did you think about her talking about anxiety and more of the other category of information?
So the things that she's referring to are likely coming from a polygenic risk score, which sometimes these direct-to-consumer tests companies will do. They're basically looking at so many different regions throughout the genome. No single location, no single mutation is known to cause these, but having this number out of the number that we looked at of these common changes can maybe increase your risk or decrease your risk of having each of those.
Yeah. So it was interesting. She seemed to be a little bit more like definitive about it when it yeah. is like a predisposition.
Yeah.
And you're like, oh, you're slightly increased risk compared to others. I also loved the title of it. What was it called? Genes and Me?
Genes and Me.
That was so cute. I was like that, you know, so just I think this is an example of one that just like makes me kind of laugh and smile and I don't get like angry. I got a little angry at Rachel Berry there.
Yeah,
but this
definitely.
One, I'm just like, this is hilarious.
Totally.
So this is a clip from Grey's Anatomy about a hereditary cancer syndrome. Mm. So neither of our areas specifically, but kind of interesting to see how much information they're giving in such a short amount of time. And definitely an early season because you can see how everybody's kind of on the young side for people that have watched Grey's for years. So let's see what Meredith Grey has to say for us.
Megan Shelley, 27, Michael Shelley, 23. Genetic testing revealed they all carry the CDH1 gene for hereditary diffuse gastric cancer.
Which means what, Dr. Grey?
Which means they all have a 3 in 4 chance of developing the cancer.
Dr. Bailey has taken tumors out of pretty much everyone on our mother's side.
Unfortunately, it's a highly aggressive cancer. The tumors grow quickly, so by the time I get in there...
Our family tree is down to a branch.
How is Uncle Bud doing?
Dead.
And Aunt Helen?
Dead.
What about the Minnesota cousin?
Not dead.
She's 90 pounds and in hospice, Meg.
Still not dead yet.
So, you've decided you're ready to take the next step.
We've made a pact. We're all in this together. Cut our stomachs out, Dr. Bailey.
So this is a condition that I feel like a lot of us are aware of. I've actually never seen a patient with this, but it can be quite a severe condition because one of the recommendations is to actually have your stomach removed.
Yeah, that it's a prophylactic surgery, meaning it's preventative. So knowing that you're at an increased risk for stomach cancer being one of them, I think the risk is a little bit low than what Dr. Grey was saying. I think it's more like 60%.
Yeah, I think it's 60.
Okay, all right, must be if we're both thinking that. And there also is a risk for breast cancer, which they don't mention.
Yeah,
and two of the individuals sitting there are female. So that was kind of interesting there. What did you think about the family history aspect?
Because this condition does come with a high risk of these cancers, it's not a surprise that we're seeing a significant family history of these cancers.
Yeah, it makes sense, especially with a big family. When you have a small family, you don't have as many people around to have developed cancer from that. We would expect that if someone has the condition that about 50% of their kids would inherit that as well. So it's interesting that all three of these siblings have had it. I don't know if they have other siblings. But at the same time, we do see that because it's a flip of a coin for each person.
Yeah.
I think this was much more comprehensive in terms of what they offered. And I would expect that from Dr. Yang and Dr. Grey. So.
Well, thank you so much for joining us. We actually have another video coming out where we're trying to solve actual cases in these videos so we can see how well we do.
Yeah, so hopefully we'll be able to solve some. We do have a degree in genetics, so we do have that on our side. So hopefully we'll be able to solve some of the cases. But yeah, I'm always really intrigued to see when genetics pops up in TV shows. If there's ones that you love, would love to see those in the comments so we could check those out for maybe a future video or something.
Absolutely. And just a reminder, definitely check out DNA Today, Kira's podcast. I'll link it down below. And thanks again for joining us.
All right. Thanks, guys.
Bye.